darkness touched you. Everyone could see it in the hollows of your eyes. A gaze averted from life. You ran from it, but brought it nearer. Led it to him. An endless suffering, worse than death. And you wanted to surrender, abandon, to find peace with the gods. No. The darkness won't allow it. So you will walk into the lair of the beast. Look it in the eye, and you will go to war. This is your mission. This is your quest. There is nothing else left.
Beim letzten wollte ich was ausprobieren, aber das hat auch nicht funktioniert. Deswegen hat er mich voll erwischt.
Every gate you open into darkness brings another challenge.
Ah, fuck, falsche Richtung ausgewichen. Alter.
Stop.
Aber ist der große da? Aber das war schon fies, Alter, dass sie dich dann da reinholen, komplett verletzen, bis du fast down bist. Und dann musst du noch den Fight machen.
The journey to Helheim is never a straight one. Each must find their own path. Align yourself to its secrets, and you will find yours. However you come to the gold-covered bridge that leads to Hell, you may find it guarded by a giantess. She will ask your name. She will ask your lineage. She will ask your business. The Northmen tell of the warrior woman Brynhild, who leapt into fire and rode to Hell to join her slain love Sigurd, and is challenged by the giantess.
Okay, das war ja cool. So ein Symbol brauchen wir noch.
Hela possesses large dwelling places in Helheim. Tall are her walls, high are her gates. The name of her dish is hunger. Her knife is famine. On her threshold all will stumble. Her bed is called sick bed, and her bed hangings are called flames of a funeral pyre. They say she is easy to recognize, half black and half the color of flesh, and her face menacing and grim.
Aber die große Frage ist, wo ist das letzte? Ah, da ging es nochmal hoch. So, mehr Fighting, oder?
The gate is opening.
Who is it?
It's coming.
That song again.
Yes, the source of the darkness. It's coming. This is your moment.
I'm sorry. I can't watch this.
What are you doing? You're showing weakness. You're not a warrior, you're a disgrace. The gods will punish you for this. Pick up the sword. Pick it up. Fight the darkness. Fight it. Get up. Get up. Get up and fight.
Oh, das war wirklich Hela? Erneut greift Hela tief in ihr Inneres. Stürmische Meer, verlorene See.
Stormy seas and lost souls. She's dreamt of this before. They say dreams are visions of our memories, thoughts and fears, as seen by our inner eye. But what if each one of us is always dreaming, even when awake? And we only see what our inner eye creates for us. Is this what hell is? A world shaped by Senua's nightmares. Maybe that's why people feared seeing the world through her eyes. Because if you believe that Senua's reality is twisted, you must accept that yours might be too.
You fail the gods. You're pathetic. Rotten. Cursed. What were you thinking? Did you really think you could win? How stupid can you be? Everyone hates her. She's cursed.
The shadow.
Look at you. A warrior. Worthless, weak, pathetic. Go on, feel sorry for yourself, because there's no one left to do that for you.
Everywhere you failed. What's that?
Take it. If you're too much of a coward to fight, then end the suffering.
Alter, dass das immer hängt, ey.
And lust, just like your sword.
Why go on? When you give everything and face that which torments you, only to find that it is worse than you could have imagined. Why go on? Is it really so weak to ask this? Or are we just so afraid of the honest answer that we do not dare pose the question? Sometimes the answer lies in a memory, a feeling, a song.
Das mit den Stimmen ist so krass, Alter. Zwei Stück erzählen, die du sollst hingehen. Eine sagt, nein, geh nicht, das ist ein Trick. Und vorhin ja auch die Haupterzählerstimme, beziehungsweise die Hauptstimme in deinem Kopf. Wie das Monster gekommen ist, so, oh, ich kann es nicht mehr ansehen. Dann war die Stimme halt einfach weg.
Zinbel made sure of that. Only occasionally did she venture out on her own, collecting firewood and herbs, errands out in the Orkney Plains. That was her world. Like this one. Barren and lonely.
Hero. His name is Sigmund. His father's hall was built around a great tree, and one day, Odin comes and thrusts a sword into the tree, a gift to whomever can release it. Many try, but the sword only comes out at Sigmund's touch. His brother-in-law, King Siggeir, wants it, but Sigmund refuses him, So King Siggeir plots revenge. He invites Sigmund and his brothers to a feast. But when they arrive, they are met with an army, not a warm welcome. King Siggeir captures Sigmund and his brothers, steals his coveted sword, and readies them for execution.
Hey, ich wollte jetzt mehr wissen. Erst wieder zur Tür.
Death for Sigmund and his brothers seems certain. But the king's wife is Sigmund's sister. And she begs for mercy and implores the king to chain them up instead. He agrees. Not for mercy, though, but because he plans an even more cruel and lingering death. Chained to a tree in the forest that night, a she-wolf comes and devours one of Sigmund's brothers. She returns, ravenous, night after night, until only Sigmund is left. The next day, Sigmund's sister sends a servant with honey to smear on Sigmund's face. But to what end? Well, that night, when the she-wolf appears again, you'll never guess what happens.
Ja, aber ich würde gern wissen, was passiert ist. Schweinerei. Hört auch nur bloß die halbe Geschichte zu erzählen. Okay, dann muss ich scheinbar zum Baum. Da würde mich dann schon wieder interessieren, ob das auf die wahren Überlieferungen zurückgeht. Also die Geschichten mit Sigmund und alles. Genau, die Leiter habe ich nämlich gesehen gehabt vorhin. Ja, ich will die Geschichte zu Ende hören, Mann.
Day after day, watching from afar, she mimicked him, perfecting her own secret dance, wishing those fleeting moments of light would stretch out to last.
As the she-wolf licks the sweet honey from Sigmund's face, he bites the wolf's tongue. The she-wolf pulls away, but Sigmund holds on. The chains break, and he is free. After his escape, Sigmund lives like us, hidden in the forest. His enemy, King Siggeir, believing him dead, as his sister plots revenge. And for vengeance to succeed, even the great Sigmund needs help. So she sends her sons to him. But their blood is weak and corrupted, and they're put to death by Sigmund. So his sister hatches a new plan, one that is cold of heart and pure of blood.
Yeah, fuck.
What's your name?
Senua.
I haven't seen you before.
I'm not. I don't leave home much.
Oh, Zeno's daughter.
I have to go.
Wait. Who taught you to fight like that?
No one.
No one?
Well, I watched you, and.
You. Learned all of that from watching me? You should become a warrior, you know.
Me?
I'm Dilly. I'm here for the warrior trials. Just come and watch. And bring your sword.
You can't put it into words. That moment when you look into the eyes of the one who's supposed to reassure you. Make you feel safe. It only takes an instant. Fear swallows you before you have a chance to make sense of it. And darkness becomes a part of who you are. But her world changed the day the Northmen took him from her. Senua knows that there's no going back to how things were. That there's nothing to go back to at all.
Stay still, stay quiet, hide, don't tell her.
Their gods can see into your mind. They will use this power to destroy you.
They won't stop me. I can still feel him.
Whatever's left of him, they will never let him go.
I'm not gonna let him rot here.
You're the one rotting here.
Leave me alone.
You will die here.
No.
And all your suffering will have been for nothing.
Shut up!
You want to believe it.
Is he
it's
there?
Not real.
Is he there?
You're alone in these mountains.
Is that Dilia?
Nothing lives here.
You won't survive.
You met him by the tree.
She met him by the tree.
Maybe it's a sign, the tree.
What's he trying to tell you?
He's waiting for you by the tree.
Sigmund's sister trades ships with a sorceress. And in disguise, she lies with her own brother. She gives birth to a son named Sinfjotli. After a time, she sends him to the forest to Sigmund. He tests the boy and finds him strong and fearless. And so they go to take their vengeance on King Siggeir. But luck is not on their side. They're captured, and Siggeir has them buried alive.
Wow, was war denn das jetzt für ein Racheplan? Das bin ich enttäuscht von der Geschichte. Die Schwester lässt sich vor ihrem eigenen Bruder durchnehmen, damit sie einen starken Nachfahren hat oder sowas. Ja, vor allem die Zeitspanne. Ist es dann auch ewig lang dazwischen, oder? Ich meine, es ist jetzt so, als ob du den Sohn nach 5 Tagen da wieder hinschicken kannst.
As Sigmund and Sinfjotli are being buried alive, Sigmund's sister throws an armful of straw into the grave mound. Hidden in the straw is Sigmund's sword, the gift of Odin. They cut their way out of the grave mound and set fire to Siggeir's hall. The king burns to death. Sigmund calls to his sister to come out so that she may live and be honored. She does come out. But only to tell him the truth. That she had slept with him, her brother, to beget a strong avenger. I am not fit to live, she says, and walks back into the fire. Strike vengeance from your heart, Senua, as there is always a heavy price to pay.
Die Geschichte hat einen interessanten Anfang, aber ein beschissenes Ende. Oh, das ist schwer. Ach, wie stimmt, wir brauchen eh neues.
Forced the dwarves to make a sword that would never fail and never rust, and that would slice through iron and stone and bring victory to its bearer. But the angry dwarves cursed it. It would be the death of a man every time it was drawn, and it would be the death of the king. Let me tell you about the sword Tyrving.
I don't recognize this place. Where are we? Where is she?
It feels wrong. Where are we now? Burial mound.
Okay.
Strange that we go to such lengths to bury.
Aber bevor wir jetzt da weitermachen, bedanke ich mich fürs Zuschauen. Dann machen wir noch das nächste Mal weiter. Sonst wird es wieder zu spät. Ist eh schon wieder zu spät. Oh, scheiße. Und ich hoffe, wir sehen uns wieder in der nächsten Folge von Hellblade. Ist ja nur ein Sacrifice. Und dann schauen wir mal, dass wir es fertig bekommen. Auf jeden Fall bis zum Release vom zweiten Teil. Dann können wir gleich weitermachen, wenn er gut wird. Wenn es so ist, wie in die Richtung, nicht schlecht. Aber ich denke mal, da wird vieles besser sein. Es ist so ein bisschen so viel hin und her und keine Ahnung. Aber so dieses ganze Szenario an sich ist schon echt geil. Aber ich sollte hier vielleicht nochmal in der Grafik schauen, ob ich irgendwas runterstellen kann. Ich meine, komm, scheiß auf die Schatten, Alter. Post-Processing. Stellt nach bei einer höheren Einstellung führt zu einer besseren Filterung an endgültigen Bildes. Raytracing ist an. Alter, kein Wunder, dass das abkackt. Jetzt wundert es mich nicht, dass das so abgeht. Raytracing ist doch eigentlich... Habe ich überhaupt eine Grafikkarte, die Raytracing kann? Keine Ahnung. Danke an der Stelle fürs Zuschauen. Macht's gut und bis zum nächsten Mal. Servus.